Because, in fact, in the World Championship match, in fact, in the last two World Championship matches, because before this, also in Brisago, Kramnik was playing against Lecco, Kramnik was always happy after d takes c4. And after a4, he was able to hold his own in lines with bishop f5, and also in lines with e6. And in a way, it is slightly surprising that Kramnik went into such sharp line with black against Topalov. This usually doesn't suit his style. Probably he expected some sort of theoretical discussion in which he thought he would be better prepared. I guess that he wanted to show the improvements for black from his own game against Aronian, which we saw some time ago, and which was played a couple of rounds prior to this game. So, all in all, Kramnik goes e6, and Topalov, although, of course, as I mentioned, he couldn't possibly expect this line, doesn't hesitate, goes for the sharpest continuation, and after bishop g3, b5, bishop e2, bishop b7, Kramnik finds himself actually on the wrong side of this line. That is, he was always playing it with white, was always was almost always successful with it, and probably by now he accumulated sufficient knowledge about it in order to feel confident with black. But for this particular game, Topalov prepared a novelty which was indeed difficult to foresee. So after knight e5, bishop g7, we have exactly the same position like in the game Kramnik Aronian, like in the game Rajabov Anand, and in so many others. And Kramnik probably did not expect anything else but knight takes d7, knight takes d7, bishop d6, and was probably going to demonstrate his lengthy theoretical knowledge there. But in this particular game, something extraordinary happened. Something which doesn't happen every day, doesn't happen every year. In fact, Topalov basically took us back to 19th century with an unusual intuitive piece sacrifice. This he just played knight takes f7.